We are live from my backyard, where I am smoking these meats, meat like a brisket. I'm making meats now. Someone asked me, do I smoke meat? That's gonna be delicious. Yeah, do I smoke meat? That's what I'm talking about. Yeah.
Welcome to East Texas Red Barn Cooking with your guy, Texas Steve. Texas T here. Get ready. It's time to do some cooking, y'all. Good evening, folks. Hope everybody's doing well with all this craziness going on around. Finally decided to turn the news off and get away from it. Do something else. Make cocktails. Let's go do some smoking. I got a really nice beef short ribs that I was going to smoke, but I waited until too late, so not going to happen. Not tonight. We'll save it for another time. But I am going to do a homemade chili that I'm going to take to a little place tomorrow. We're supposed to be getting together for St. Patty's Day little gathering. If they don't wind up shutting it down, I doubt it, but I heard today on the news that they were shutting down all bars and gyms and restaurants and theaters in Dallas. So I hadn't made it out here yet. Oh, just in case. One got stocked up. Just in case. So anyway, I'm just going to do a chili tonight. About to make me a homemade chili. That's my stash. Anyway, about to do a homemade chili for St. Patty Day thing tomorrow.
Yeah, got a phone call. Gotta knock out my video, but that's alright. We're gonna do this homemade chili. Instead of using ground beef, turn this thing on, weigh it out. Alright. So I'm gonna put about almost a pound of a steak that I grilled. I'm gonna cube it up, chop it up, and then I'm gonna put maybe a half a pound or so of this really lean, the round eye. I'm gonna cube it up, chop it up, along a pound of sausage, peppers, onions, some seasonings, and we're gonna get this chili going. We're gonna chop this up really good, really good, good little fine little cubes. Do this. Chopped up now. I'm gonna throw that in the skillet, brown that up along with the sausage. The rest of this, like I said, this is a rye eye round. It's very lean, so that's what I use for my beef jerky. I'll make beef jerky out of the rest of that. It's tough meat, but as it cooks in that chili all night long, it's gonna be just fine, just fine. But anyway, we're gonna brown these babies up and get this chili going, baby. Oh, this is a certified steak. Already grilled, certified steak. Certified Angus is Nolan Ryan's certified Angus. This is also certified Angus, but I don't know whose it is. But anywho, you don't have to do it like this. It's a lot tougher to do this way. You can buy chili meat or stewed meat or whatever, ground beef. But they had a good deal on this, and I thought, oh, I know what I'm gonna do with that. So that's what I'm doing.
Man, it smells so good. That sausage and the chopped eye of round. I threw some garlic salt in there actually. I don't usually use garlic salt, very little, very seldom. Of course, I put regular garlic in there too, garlic powder. But man, it smells good. Finally, got all my ingredients ready. So I can make this bad boy of a homemade chili. That's how daddy does it.
Texas tea style.
Got all that meat together. We're gonna dump in these peppers and onions. Let those cook down. And a couple of teaspoons of minced garlic. Turn it around and then, oh man, it's gonna be good. It's gonna be good. Had to pull out the big boy. Too much stuff, but that's all right. It's gonna be so good. Let that stuff cook down a bit.
Alright, so we've got this mixture for our chili, for our meats, and our peppers, and our onions, and our garlic. All ready to go into this crock pot. We'll crock pot this shit all night long. I always use a ladder. Makes it so much easier to clean. Because I am the chef here. I am the maid here. So, the easier I can make it on myself, that's what I do. We'll put all this meat mixture in it. Had to pull out the big boy. Skillet here, pot, whatever the hell it is. I doubled up pretty much everything. My meat's pretty much doubled. My ingredients is doubled or came close to it. Hey, Critter, what are you doing playing right here? Living in Texas in the springtime, leaving the door open. Alright, so, where'd he go? I'll get his ass. Anywho, so we got all our delicious meat mixture right here. Then we're gonna start pouring stuff in. There he is. Come on. Go that way. Broth. My broth I make out of bouillon. Well, good God Almighty. I'm gonna close the door real quick. Let me take care of that business real fast. With electricity. Be right back. All right, now that we've taken care of the springtime nuisance here in Texas, whether the mayflies or something like that, I don't know. But we electrocuted them, fried them on up, threw them here in the pot. We're happy to be good to go. Anywho, so I got my bouillon, my broth. I use your bouillon. We're gonna pour that baby in there, just a little bit. Get a little bit of liquid in there. And I'll put, I'm gonna try to remember to put all these ingredients down in the description. And that way I'm gonna save a little bit. So I can pour it on top of these seasonings and get it good mixed up. So we're gonna get started here with diced tomatoes. I got a big can of diced tomatoes. This here is 28 ounces. And I'm putting it all in there. Every bit of it. Tomato sauce, 8 ounce can. It's in there. Tomato paste, you know, I'm not gonna double up on this. I pretty much doubled up on everything else, but I'm gonna keep this at about 3 ounces of tomato paste. Don't want to overdo it with that. All right. And let's see here. We got, these are pinto beans.
But these have flavor to it. They are a mild chili. They have a mild chili sauce with them. So I'll figure out, see what the heck, what this is like. What it tastes like. I'll put an old can in there. Juice enough. Then I have a mix of chili bean, kidney, and pinto beans. And I'm putting it in there. And you know what? I was going to put another can, but I'm not too sure that I want to do that. Not too sure I want to do that. So we'll hold off on that. We'll hold off on the last can. What I'm going to add to that, I got some Hatch diced green chilies. I'm putting that whole can in there. Got a second can of Hatch diced green chilies. I'm putting that whole can in there. We're going to light it up a little bit. What else I have here? Got a little cup of my juice. Worcestershire sour sauce, a little bit of liquid smoke, probably a tablespoon of liquid smoke, and 2 tablespoons of habanero hot sauce. It's going in there. Yes, sir, it is. Oh, then all of our seasonings. Got the salt, paprika, we got chili powder, I've got, I don't remember. I'll put it in the description. We're going to put all that in there. That's all going in there. Cumin. That's what the other one was. Cumin. And that's why I saved the rest of my liquid. That way I can pour on top of that. It's kind of soak it down, get it wet, and make it a little easier to mix up. I tell you, man, this smells good already. We haven't thrown it on the fire yet. It made it start cooking and then, but man, it smells good. Of course, the garlic and the onions and everything with the meat, that smells fantastic anyway. And if I need to add anything later, well, we'll be tomorrow morning because I'm going to let this baby cook. I'm going to let it cook all night long. It is 11:30 at night, and this thing's going to cook all night long. Slowly. Anything else I need to add to this thing? I think I got it. I think that's about it. So, we're going to throw this thing into the little heating crock over there. Let it do its thing. And I might need to add some liquid to it. You know, tomorrow morning, we'll find out. I'll taste it. Might need to add some more cumin to it or whatever. I did omit brown sugar. I didn't, that was on my last recipe. So I doubled everything up pretty much and omitted that. That I won't be adding, but I'll taste it in the morning. And, you know, if I need more cumin or chili powder or salt, you know, whatever, we'll adjust accordingly. So, anyway, that's ready to start cooking. So, we're going to throw it in there and let it do it to it. Here's to you.
Baby, looks so good. Smells wonderful. All right. The smell of this woke me up. It has been slow cooking all night. Oh my goodness, it smells so good. Oh, I can't wait to try it. Homemade chili.
All right, we're gonna give this goodness a little taste. It is the next morning. It is hot, heat wise. So I better let it cool down a second. Get a little spoonful here. Smells wonderful. Oh boy.
I can't wait.
Oh my God. I thought I might have to add some things to it this morning. No. Doubling up on those ingredients because I had a lot more meat. Wow. That is fantastic. There you go. Do it to it. Happy St. Patty Day.